Have you ever wondered where your tax money goes to?
The welfare system in America was created to assist needy families. It has served its purpose, but it has also failed because it creates a sense of dependency. Now more than ever, more and more Americans are applying for welfare benefits because of the national economic situation at hand. This is perfectly understandable. What's not understandable is people abusing those benefits.
There are benefits that provide for the supplements, shelter, healthcare, and even extra money for the people in need. All right, can you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Okay, I'm 30 years old. I have 4 kids, and I've been on welfare for 12 years.
Some people are on welfare for a short period of time, while others take advantage and are on it for generation after generation.
Do you live in government housing?
Yes, since I was 18, but they put me out because I didn't report my boyfriend living there with me.
This so-called generational welfare limits the potential and motivation to succeed for its recipients. Many recipients live in government housing, commonly known as projects. The majority of these projects are high crime areas due to the influence that poverty has in these living places. The amount of government financial assistance that gets pumped into these communities doesn't really assist. It creates dependency. Are you employed?
No.
How do you feel about that?
I'm comfortable with it, and I feel like I don't need to look for one because I get a check from the government every month.
How much do you collect in benefits?
I get $780 in food stamps, $500 in tenants, and I get Medicaid and WIC.
And I, as somebody who worked in low-income neighborhoods, I've seen it, where people weren't encouraged to work, weren't encouraged to upgrade their skills, were just getting a check, and over time, their motivation started to diminish.
Have you ever sold your food stamps?
Yes, I did for $100, and I got $60 in cash.
Do you feel like you're cheating the system or abusing it?
Nah, bro, it's free money.
Kiara is just one example of many others who are out there taking advantage and abusing your tax dollars.
Fraud investigators knew something was wrong as they surveilled their suspect. Behind the wheel of a $40,000 Cadillac Escalade, Kim Johnson. She is on public assistance. She claimed that she was disabled, in need of 24-hour care, and that she was poor. Instead, she pulls up to a Sue Ann's Beauty Supply, a store she owns. DA investigators say that Johnson and two partners also bought a house. Together, they're accused of a $417,000 ripoff.
In 2004, food stamp coupons were replaced by the EBT card. State officials have said that they prefer this electronic system because it is more simple to administer and help reduce fraud and abuse by eliminating the paper coupons that can be lost, sold, or stolen. Over the years, food stamps had been sold on the black market and used as a form of currency to buy narcotics and other contraband. The Florida State Legislature has recently proposed a bill that would bar people from using food stamps to pay for candy, soft drinks, and other junk food. The bill would also prevent people from using their EBT cards at ATMs in casinos or strip clubs, or from accessing cash out of state. States like Georgia, Florida, Colorado, and Nebraska have proposed to commence drug testing welfare applicants and recipients. The state of Florida had already begun doing so until a judge ordered to halt the drug tests. The state saw a 10% increase in the number of people applying for welfare benefits after that order. Some people are calling these drug tests unconstitutional. How is this unconstitutional? It's okay to drug test people who work for their money, but not those who don't. The best solution possible is educating the American youth. The target needs to be middle and high school age kids in order to make them realize the consequences of generational welfare and welfare abuse. By providing the proper education, we can start making the correct changes that are needed in our welfare system.